got a complaint.
What, emeralds?
Look, you want them all tight, yeah? Bar tight, right? Every one of them.
20 years, pal.
Yeah, look, don't give me any of that shite. Just
years.
Do your job, all right?
You've got the hang of it for now.
All right, don't give me any of all that shite. Hey, just do your job, mate. Just
see,
do your
see this?
Job. Hey, we're working to a finish.
What?
We're working to a finish.
Well, what's fucking new then?
I think I know where it is.
Oh. Get a blue off the fucking rag man for these.
To your finish?
Yeah. I haven't found the missus yet.
Keep the milkman on his toes.
Oh, fuck off.
What are you doing, Tommy?
What's it look like?
There are Johns.
Hi, hi, hey. Come on, this isn't working.
I'm a throw in the fucking doctor.
Yeah, come on, let's be having your heart to ask you. Come on, put the shawls away. Get back to work.
Wish I had a coat as thick as him.
Done it all last night.
Yeah, I just forgot this little bit.
Your footy shirt, Daddy?
No, you lied to me.
I didn't lie, I just forgot.
Something today.
I'm not a mind reader. No telly for you tonight.
I've done my homework.
Thomas, you haven't put your shoes on. Go upstairs, put your shoes on, and come down again.
What's
you?
Toast?
What? You've ripped pages out of my book.
Your wife and it's French and she goes ballistic.
What do you want to do that for?
Why were you in my room last night? You know you're not allowed in there.
Sorry.
You left here last night to go to work.
Well, room
where has he been?
Well, how did you get my book to rip the pages out?
What time this morning?
Oh, yeah, well,
right. I'll tell him.
No,
bye.
I hate this
house. Mum, I never touched the book.
Oh, yeah. This fucking fat wallet.
I'll
last them to five.
It's got you on £4 an hour. We're on £10 an hour. You think you're going to be getting £10 an hour as well, don't you? Well, you won't. We'll be down to fucking £4 like you fellas. That's if we're not out on our day, eh? Because you know what we're doing? We're training you to take our fucking jobs off us.
Hey, Macca, you're out of order now.
No, I'm not, Tommy.
He voted for them to come in the dock.
I didn't vote for them.
Jockey.
What was she like?
What?
What was she like?
Who?
You haven't been on the ale. And you haven't been working. So unless the betting shop's certain round the bloody clock, that only leaves one thing.
You're working me bollocks off all night, woman.
But it hasn't been down the dock. You've been with some tart. They phoned.
Been working all night.
Oh, yeah.
They made a mistake.
I made the mistake marrying you.
For Christ's sake, woman!
Somebody phoned her. Somebody
who's been
working when I was.
What are you asking me for? I don't know.
This is him again. Batting around, so you phone her, right? Phone her and put her straight.
Is this down to you?
I don't know anything about that.
Hey, don't know what you're worried about. You'll never get a bit on the side, you ugly get.
Fuck off.
Tommy, lad, I'm going to get all kinds of shite over my trousers.
I don't know anything about that.
Shite? The last time I saw any dirt on you, it was fucking Ash Wednesday.
Is that you?
John Speech.
Fucking hell.
Athlete's fuss.
What athlete? You?
Shop putter. A solo meal, a bet challenge.
You couldn't pull a sick off his back with a lariat. See more life in an urgent note. If you won't put your back into it, I'll find someone who will. All right, yeah. Hey, Tommy!
Yeah.
Your 2 days off start today.
You can go and piss off, right? Just go piss off.
Well,
you know what?
Well,
I'm doing nights. I spent my first fucking day off in bed.
Yeah.
I'm fucking sick of it, right? I'm sick of you pulling this stunt.
Don't you like it?
No! Then fucking lump it! There's millions out there, lad, millions!
Hey, Harry! Come here!
Take no notice, he's a dickhead!
Good night.
Cracked.
How's me man?
Don't ask.
Doghouse?
Yeah. How's the baby?
She's got a sticky eye, like, but she's all right.
What's that?
It's not. See ya.
No.
And I want the change.
All right.
Hiya.
You late?
Thomas. How did you get these in this state?
I don't know.
Did they phone?
Can you pass that back to Thomas? One of you got £2 for Seda. Give us that fiver back.
Why?
Taking a fiver to school.
I told you I was working.
Perhaps.
You're satisfied I was working?
Car. Good friend of yours, was he?
Ew.
The supervisor.
For God's sake, woman, I was working!
Sorry.
But you're all right.
Dad.
He's got good mace, I know that.
Oh, are you? Our people have the bloody bones of him.
Your people be copping off a girl soon. I want my lad to do the same. Copping off with girls, playing footy. I know I'm being greedy. But when that car hit him, they told me he was gonna die. I just wanted him to live. Even as a cabbage, you know, that'd do. Just let him live. And he lived. And then I thought, let him smile. Just one little smile. And he smiled. Then I thought, let him talk. He talked. Let him walk. And he walked. I know I'm getting greedy. Greedier all the time. But it's not for me, it's for my lad. I just want my life to be perfect again.
What are you doing, Tommy? Your Andy's a good kid.
Mrs. Dan Hedrick,
yes.
Yeah!
You try and unload this?
That's an unsafe stow. You only got to look at it to know that. You don't go near it unless you got one of us with you. Unless you've got an experienced docker with you, right?
Well, I pollocked a lot of them, Tommy.
They're going to kill yourself. You don't even know what day it is, and you're going to kill yourself.
All right, Tommy, give it
back. Lad, please. Jesus.
Bollocks, a lot of them, lad. They're all a gang of knobheads.
Your mum and dad! Bathroom's estate and all.
Hiya.
Hiya. Okay.
Where's
my
little angel? Where are you, my love?
This is how I was out of order.
It's all right, Dad.
You're using sterilized water? Yeah. Dip the cotton ball. Filled out an accident report.
It's all crap, Dad. Listen, I haven't said nothing to you.
I'm taking her to the clinic tomorrow.
Well, you pick all kinds of James up from the clinic. It's probably where she got this from. Oh, that bloody Charmander. You wipe away from the eye, right? Get that off! Never use the same wipe twice. Right? Don't. Bathroom's a mess. I'll kill her.
Hey, we're working to a finish.
What?
I said we're working to a finish.
Don't think I can do it.
Hey, think again.
2 hour block.
Look, I can't do it, honest. You're gonna have to do it.
Look, I never knock back overtime, you know that, but I've gotta get off at 4. I've gotta take my wife and baby to clinic.
You're working to a finish.
Is it 2 hour blocks?
No.
Oh, come on. There's a long standing agreement about overtime.
Look, you get paid the hours you work, no more.
You can't just give it like
the
that.
The hours you work, no more.
We're not doing it.
You what?
I can't do it. I'm going to see Bradley.
Hey, you walk off the ship and you're finished.
You're getting back to work.
If you pay us the proper rate for the job.
Are you getting back to work?
Mr. Bradley, you tried this last week. It's overtime and we want the overtime rate.
Are you getting back to work?
Not without the overtime.
You're sacked. You getting back to work?
I can't. I gotta take my wife and baby to the clinic.
You're sacked. And you're sacked. And you're sacked. And you're fucking sacked and all.
When have you been for the circus, do you like?
You're sacked. Hiya.
Oh, how's I been?
All right, just the same. Have you been all right?
Yeah, check out all day. Yes. What's wrong?
Been sacked.
What?
Get sorted tomorrow. Come on, jump in. Jump in, come on. Take it to the clinic. Yeah.
That's coming down!
Hey, what are you doing?
It's a wild cat! It's got fuck all to do with a TNG! I can see TNG! I can see it from a fucking mile away! And you can get a proper union in it!
We are a fucking union, you're our officer!
You haven't gone through the proper channels. There's a procedure.
What about them?
You don't just walk off the fucking job!
Jack, they haven't
gone through the proper channels either.
We had an agreement about overtime, they dissed it and then they sacked us.
We'll pick at Seaforth if we have to.
Oh, you leave Seaforth out of this. Seaforth's Mersey Docks. You are Torside. You're an independent company, nothing to do with Mersey Docks.
What about Tanger?
Don't you go telling him it's a TNG system.
Look at him, Jack. Who does he work for?
Mersey Docks.
Right. He was our boss on the ship. He's Mersey Docks. How can we have nothing to do with Mersey Docks when we went to his orders?
right.
Keep away from Seaforth.
Answer his questions, Jack.
And listen, I want to see no fucking change here on any fucking banner, right?
Please, fucking question.
You
quality
idiot.
Yeah. Think
it's
safe, we need to register Dockers out. We need to sort it, won't we? Behave.
I'll reinstate the five of them.
I'm not asking you to reinstate them.
You're their union official.
Aye. And I've been on the bloody picket line, and I'm telling you, I've got no control over them whatsoever. I'm not asking for reinstatement.
And I object to seeing one now. I think they've got a fucking...
Well, you're going to cross it?
No, I'm not going to cross it. I'm no
right.
Fucking scabble. They've only been here 5 fucking minutes.
No,
I've been on this
dock
half me fucking life.
5 years, mate.
I think they've got a fucking cheat. That's all I'm saying. I think they've got a fucking cheat.
The timber. Let them pick at the timber on our fucking gate.
How can we? The timber's through there, and we can't get through there because we've been sacked off there.
Let's have none of this official arc, right? These lads have been unfairly dismissed. And I know that we're going to respect their picket line.
No one's going to cross it, Jimmy, for God's sake. But they want to sack us, don't they? And if we don't turn in for work, that's it. They'll fucking do it, won't they? There's got to be a better
way. Do you mean scab it?
No, I don't mean scab it. Let the fucking union sort it out. Proper fucking channel.
Jack Dempsey couldn't sort letters.
You're saying cross this picket line. That's basically what you're saying. And I'm ashamed of you. The only thing that's made this job half decent. It's solidarity, and you're saying, sod that, let's scab it.
I'm no fucking scab, Jimmy, and you know that. But I'm saying, we're walking into a trap.
But what choice have we got? Are we going to cross the picket line?
No!
Then what choice have we got? Right, we respect this picket line. We meet in the Dockers Club in an hour. All those in favour?
Yes.
Against? Carried, unanimous.
Nice one, Jimmy. Yeah.
Over in no time, lad, okay.
Dockers, dismissed by Liverpool-based Torside, today spread their picket to Seaforth. Seaforth men refused to cross the Torside picket, and Liverpool docks have been brought to a standstill. A spokesman for the Torside Dockers has said the picket will remain in place until all the sacked Torside men are reinstated. Tonight's further headlines, police are investigating bogus calls to pilots landing at Manchester Airport. Greater Manchester police say if these...
If it hadn't have been this, it would have been something else. They've been trying to sack us for years.
Fine, but if you're going to fight, don't tie one hand behind your back.
Come again?
The dispute's illegal.
It isn't.
We're advised that it is. And if we support it, we'll get the union sued. And we are not going to do that, Jimmy. We've got 1 million members to look after, not just the Dockers.
So you'll do nothing?
We'll do what we can. But we stay within the law.
We. What about you, Bill? Hey, what do you think?
Is that relevant?
Cool, mate.
Lance?
Yeah, Longchamps, the races.
Do any good?
Won a few, Bob, yeah.
What do you do?
Docker.
Oh, unlucky.
Hey?
You don't know, do you?
Oh, hello, son. Have
Hiya, Ma.
Nice time.
Oh, oh great.
Yeah, come and have a cup of tea.
I phoned you every night. Why didn't you tell me I'd been sacked?
Well, I didn't want to spoil your holiday.
Yeah.
Ooh, nice one. Oh, hey, we'll save that for something special, eh?
Port shop shoots, please. John McCauley, Jimmy. How can they sack a man on holiday?
If they'd sacked us and left it at that, you could argue that it was some kind of principled stance. But they've never left it at that. They've issued 200 offers with new contracts. Non-negotiable contracts.
Contracts?
They're trying to seize yeah. commercial advantage.
Have you got one?
Yeah.
Well, how come I haven't?
Because you're an idle bastard.
Without the redundancy money. We've looked at the contracts, lads. And they're a joke. They're an absolute disgrace.
Look, we all go back together and know it all.
We'll be turning the clock back 70 years. And we're not going to do that. So our recommendation is dignified return to work, followed by negotiations.
Why have you sacked 500 Liverpool dockers?
We never sacked 500 Liverpool dockers.
The dockers sacked themselves when they refused to cross that picket line. They will not be coming back into the port of Liverpool.
Meanwhile, amongst the dockers themselves, there's anger.
Only a few months ago, the Mersey docks shall be with the most productive workforce in Europe.
The outlook's bleak for the Liverpool dockers. On to other news now, yes. And Shadow Home Secretary Jack Straw.
Ta-ra.
See you, Mark.
Ta-ra, Queen.
Ta-ra.
We'll be back in no time.
Yeah.
What are you fucking doing?
I'm eating this off his buzzy.
We're fighting for our fucking jobs over there, and there's all sorts getting through. Get your asses on the fucking picket line, will you?
Who does he think he is, Che Guevara?
Mr. Torside, lads.
We're here.
You started all this, you know. You cost me my fucking job. We're at you all.
We're here, right?
Malt.
Torside, man. Right, when this kicked off, you know when you're on the picket this morning, 26. Well, 2 weeks, no one's seen you in 2 weeks. That's not on, Mickey. Come on. We cost these men their jobs. The least we can do is turn out for them. Mickey, don't put the phone down on me. Mickey, if you put the phone down, I'll come round you.
You don't love this, you're not real.
Where are you going? Make the same with your pizza.
Not so much in Italy, more in this country.
Isn't that curious?
There's a scab living there! A dirty, rotten, stinking scab living there!
Excuse me, isn't there a meeting here tonight?
No, it's not.
It's cancelled.
Yeah, no.
You knew?
Didn't know you were going, did I?
If I told you, you'd try to stop me.
What do you know?
It's conked out on Lime Street.
Lime Street?
For God's sake, woman, I think you're on the game.
What does she make on Lime Street?
£14.10.
Gave you £10?
They upped it.
Over.
Sarge, why don't you come and see for yourself? Kathy can't make it. Do you want to go first or second?
Speaking.
And we're not stripping.
They're all teachers. I can't talk to them.
You've got to.
Oh, God.
Jean is the wife of a sack docker. I'm sure you'll give her a warm NUT welcome.
This is the third time in an hour I've got off a warm seat with a piece of paper in my hand. A week before this dispute started, I went to pick up my husband, the Seaforth dog. I saw an old man coming towards me. He got a bit nearer. I realised it was the man that I married. And then I realised what that job was doing to him. Killing him. He'd get home drained after a 14-hour shift. The phone would go, telling him to turn in 6 the next morning. We stopped making arrangements with friends, because the phone would go, we'd have to let them down. It got so bad, we taught our own kids to lie. If that's the Maisie Dock's your mum and dad are out. That's what it was like on the dock before this dispute started. And I know that you'll identify with that, because it's happening to teachers as well. It's happening to us all. Yes, you're lucky to have a job. My God, don't they let you know it? They make you work harder and harder, longer hours, false short-term contracts on you, take away your job security. The whole of this country is being casualised. This is not about some antwacky labour force sticking to some antwacky principles. This is the most modern dispute imaginable. Liverpool dockers and their wives and families have stood shoulder to shoulder for 3 months now. And if it goes on for 3 years, we'll still stand shoulder to shoulder. We won't lose, you see, because we can't lose. We've got nowhere else to go. Thank you.
Dead man walking.
Is it Welsh or New Zealand?
You're going to cook it? They don't talk to him. Or does she set up a kitchen back?
Oh, where you should talk. You wouldn't get a kiss in the leather colony.
Hey, you sipped on legs, mate.
Oh, yeah, and how much do you want to house then?
You're having another.
What time is it?
Ah, come on, you're having another.
Absolutely brilliant day tonight, girl.
Oh, thanks.
You're having one?
No, I'm going on to take the wife's knickers off.
Bit tight on you, Andy.
Are you still up? Hiya.
Where have you been?
The only two people.
All night?
I went for a drink after.
We?
Me, Nolan, and a few of the dockers.
Kathy?
She didn't turn up. I had to speak.
You went on your own?
Yeah.
Only a woman and a gang of men?
They're your mates.
You no money?
No.
Yeah, I had a few.
Aren't you going to ask me how it went? I had to speak.
A gang of men buying you ale. A gang of men buying you ale all night.
Don't be upsetting him. Go upstairs.
How'd you get home?
Go on, son. Go upstairs. You can put your
How'd you get
on.
Home? Go on. How'd you get home?
Taxi.
You'd no money.
They dropped me off.
Who?
Your mates.
Why didn't you phone?
I didn't think.
Yeah, haven't you got a time?
Yeah. I was having a good time. I did something that I've never done before. I spoke in public. And to a gang of teachers as well. And they all clapped and cheered. They all clapped and cheered, and I felt good because I wanted it to last.
You won't do it again.
What?
You won't do it again.
Go upstairs.
I know what this is about.
Thomas, go upstairs. What's it about?
Money.
What?
Money. Well, I'm bringing home the money. Everything's fine. As soon as it stops, that's it. You're like some airy-ass lezzie laying down the law.
Nothing to do with money.
If you think you're going to get away with that, you can think again,
look. To do with money?
I'm still the man of this house.
Scab.
Maybe I lost my job, but I haven't lost my balls. You're in my alehouse, knocking back here with my mates.
You don't know what you're talking about.
I'm at home minding the kids.
You don't know what you're talking
about.
How
does that look? I'm on the picket line tomorrow. They're telling me what my missus was up to last night.
It's Kenny.
Sod Kenny!
For God's sake, Tommy. I spoke about you. I spoke about you because I wanted to help. You selfish bastard! I wanted to help!
It doesn't help if you're on the bloody air all night! Doesn't help if you treat your own husband like shite!
The workers united will never be defeated! The workers united will never be defeated! The workers united will never be defeated!
Boundaries. Trade unionism will know no boundaries.
And we will say to the ship owners, okay, you can load your ships with scab labor at Liverpool, but you will not see them unloaded in any other port in the world.
Yeah! In the United States, every worker has the right to obey his conscience. And if his conscience tells him not to cross a picket line, he need not cross it. I can tell you right now, back home, there is a picket line around an ACL vessel. Victory to the Liverpool Dockers!
Christmas present here.
Can I have it now, please?
Did you hear it? Did you tell me where you got it?
Yeah, off Mickey Mouse.
So, everyone, konnichiwa.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Nice. Prunes. Get your Christmas prunes. Come on, get your prunes.
Just need prunes.
Oh, yeah. That's all right for him, isn't it? I don't need to go. All the best, lad. Have a nice Christmas.
It's almost the same.
Yeah. Told you to be one of the first, didn't I?
Well, someone's got to be first, haven't he?
You're never first on the pickle line, though, are you? You leave that to mugs like me.
Yeah.
What's this?
A fucking duck.
What the fuck do we do with a duck?
Cook the fucking thing.
Yeah, well, she wants a turkey.
You're not getting a turkey. The men who turn up on the pickle line, they're getting turkeys. You're getting a duck. Chuck.
It was frozen.
Yeah.
Well, how long does it take to thaw?
He'll thaw out quicker than I do when I get home off the pickle line. Now, fuck off.
About toys?
Toys?
Yeah.
Your lad's 18 years of age. What does he want? A blow up fucking doll?
We don't want to get sued by Calvin Bleeding Klein.
Hey, look, the Jaffy wants one.
Hey! Don't, he doesn't reverse the Jaffy.
It's okay to advertise Nike and Reebok, but as soon as Robbie Fowler supports people from his own community, he lands in trouble. So much for modern-day football.
We gave some T-shirts to the Everton players as well, like in case they scored a goal. We're still waiting. Again.
Association today announced that it intends to speak to Robbie Fowler about his gesture of solidarity with the Liverpool Dockers. The Dockers themselves, however, have thanked the player.
Football used to be a working class game. If Robbie Fowler gets fined by the FA, we'll do the working class thing. We'll have a whip round for him. We just wish people closer to us could be as supportive as Robbie Fowler.
I tell you this when my grandchildren say to me in 15, 20, 25 years' time, where were you when the Liverpool Dockers were fighting for their jobs, their community, their dignity, and their pride? I want to be able to say I was there marching with them side by side. I'll tell you why we are going to win this dispute. Because we've got something they don't understand, they can't cope with, they can't deal with, and it's called solidarity. I'm here to speak on behalf of our union. I'm here to say to you that whatever happens, our spirit will never be broken and our bellies will never be starved. Because, comrade, you in Liverpool will never walk alone. Good luck and victory to the Liverpool Dockers.
Watch him.
Do you believe in the union? I mean, really believe in it, like your dad does.
No. No. Not like me dad does. No way.
I feel like taking the baby over there and saying to her, look at us. Your husband sacked my husband. He's got a wife, a baby, a mortgage. Plans for the future. That'd have more effect on her than anything the union could do.
She'll just go back inside, won't she? She's not going to get involved.
She is involved, Andy. She's his wife.
Right, come on.
Right, this is the number of the Dockers Club. If you phone, ask for your dad, because he never in, right?
Right, taxi's waiting for sure.
Just give me a bottle and she should sleep right there. I'll phone about 10, half 10, just to...
Come on, he's trying to make a living.
Come on. You
don't want to
come. See you later.
I've been fighting him, Tommy.
I'm gonna have a word.
Don't spoil the girl's wedding, Tommy. It's not worth it.
What's going on?
You all right?
What's going on?
My kid's here. I knew nothing about it.
What are you doing?
Going with him.
He can look after himself.
Gonna watch his back.
Andy!
Shit house.
You done right by your son, Tommy. I done right by mine.
What?
You can cross the picket line because your lad was on it. Well, my lad fucking wasn't. I tried to get him on the top, but I couldn't.
It was a picket line.
I fucking tried to, but I couldn't.
It was a picket line. I don't give a fuck whose son was on it. What do you want? Do what?
No. I'm staying here.
Just do what?
Hey, lay one finger in me, then.
I can look after this fella.
You scabby fucking bastard.
Fuck off, Marcy.
Just do one! Fucking do one. Fucking dickhead. Them Torside men are not worth a carrot, and you know it. You couldn't pull the tail off a chocolate fucking mouse. And you think I'm going to lose my job over the shower of minge bags like that? You've got another thing coming.
Got the wrong night, didn't I? Two fucking buses as well.
I'm gonna look after my own from now on, Tommy.
Now I'm giving up. Can't afford them.
You're right for me, kids, they're my principles from now on. Takes a bit of fucking bottle to stick to it and all.
Oh, fuck off.
Hey, and it takes a bit of fucking bottle to cross that picket line every morning with all hands yelling, fucking scab and blacklead, I can fucking tell you. Hey, if you want to know what it feels like, you want to fucking try it sometime, don't you?
We have a go on your own.
But you come on your fucking own. Don't bring the fucking renter mob with you and see how you fucking like it.
You never go on your own. You come in the backs of cars and fucking balaclavas. Is that fucking courage, is it?
You think you can win?
Yeah!
What support are you getting in this country?
We got support from all over the world, mate.
Come on, Tommy, you're not fucking soft. A few fucking pop singers because they'd come for business. Their fucking business. Hey, a few left-wing fucking comics who like the T-shirts. Rent a mob and a few fucking unwashed hippies. That's the total amount of support you've got in this fucking country. Will he be here when it's all over? Will he shite? You're sexy to them, lad, don't you know that? Working class struggle's always fucking sexy to people that's never known it.
You're a fucking scab.
Oh, no, Ed, you fucking listen. No, you fucking listen. The miners got beat.
Yeah, because of scabs like you.
Oh, no, no, those thousands of lads from Yorkshire, Scotland and Wales were the leader that led them the fucking front, and they still got beat. And what have you got? A few hundred area-ass stockers in a union that couldn't win a raffle with a wanker like Morris in charge. Not even official, Tommy. It's fucking doomed, lad, can't you see? It's doomed. They were offering 200 jobs, Tommy. You should have fucking grabbed one.
They did offer me a job. Didn't offer you one. That's why I stayed out.
I know. And that's why I went in. It's fucking easy to be brave when you're wanted. But when you're not even fucking wanted.
Your mates go?
Pictures.
Them girls?
Yep.
What are you reading? Pete's dad was there tonight.
Was there a fight?
Nobody wanted to spoil the wedding. Is that why you don't hang around with Pete anymore? Because his dad's a scab.
Yeah.
It's not Pete's fault. What?
You think I'm desperate, don't you? Billy no mates.
No.
Yeah. Just because I'm like this. Just because of that accident. You think I should hang around with anyone who will have me?
I don't think that at all. Good night, son.
Well, first of all, may I welcome anyone who hasn't been to the House of Commons before. This is the Education and Employment Subcommittee. It was agreed that we would look at the strike in the Port of Liverpool.
Dempsey returned later. Told me he'd been manhandled by the pickets. And he told me there'd be no appeal on behalf of the five men who were sacked, even though I offered to reinstate them.
He told Jack Dempsey to take them back. He offered to reinstate them. You're telling me that our union, a union that's done nothing for us as this thing started, could have stopped it at day one. There was never any need for the picket line. The Southside men could have been reinstated, yeah?
Yeah.
betrayed us. A union I've been loyal to all my working life has betrayed me.
There's never a good time. The usual thing is a piece from the Old Testament and a piece from the New. I've marked a few here you might like to use.
I don't know, mate.
Haven't you?
You'd better see me, man.
Jack. Would you like to help carry the coffin?
Yeah.
The dockers will carry the coffin.
I am a docker.
No, son. You're a scab.
I think John was 22 stone. There'll be no work in the well there.
Bastard, whoever he was. heaven's sakes, in life? What's the matter with you? What's going on? That's madness, mate. Fuck's sake. Madness.
Andrew James Walton, you will be fined £250. How will you pay it?
Slowly and reluctantly.
Do you have a loyalty card?
Anthony Charles Linton Blair, the Labour Party candidate, 33,000.
Well?
Well, what?
I'm waiting for an answer.
You never asked a question.
Oh, didn't I? Well, I better rephrase it then, hadn't I? Better put us in the form of a fucking question. How come she can look like that and you end up looking like that?
She's younger than me.
No, she isn't. She just looks after herself, doesn't she? And she doesn't do it for her, she does it for them, out of respect. She hasn't let herself go to fucking seed. Now, she thinks too much of him, too much respect for him. She doesn't take him for granted.
Hey,
where are you going?
I'm going to let him know what I think of him.
That's exactly what he wants.
Will you let me go, Peter?
Sit down.
Will you please let me go?
Park your ass there and just watch the television. Peter, make a cup of tea.
No.
Make a cup of tea!
No!
Hey! I'm talking to you! Hey! Come back here! Come give it to me back!
But we forecast that Labour is indeed going to be on these government benches with no fewer than 409 seats. The Conservatives are going to have to make the painful journey across here to the opposition benches.
I'll let Tony Blair know how deeply we all feel about the Liverpool docks dispute. Don't worry about that.
How will you do it?
It's very approachable.
Oh,
this is the only country in Europe where you can get done for refusing to cross the picket lines. Did you know that? No, the Tories have got a lot to answer for. This country's laws have been condemned by the councils of Europe. Did you know that? Yes, and we'll address it. Minimum wage, new legislation.
Yeah, what about us then?
We have to be careful before we get involved in any industrial dispute.
You are involved. The government owns 12% of Mersey Docks.
Victory to the Liverpool Dockers. Yeah!
For me. Can't do any more for you, Jimmy.
But you don't have to do anything. ACL left Liverpool because you threatened to black it. Just threaten it again.
Well, what's your own union doing?
Well, we've got anti-trade union laws over here, you know that. And if our union is seen
That's
to be...
Bullshit.
If they're seen to be condoning...
I am facing a $6 million lawsuit because my men helped the Liverpool dockers. Now, how can I justify that when your own fucking union isn't lifting a finger?
You can't.
I'm here. I could have every transport union in the world on your side. All your general secretary has to do is give the word. He won't give it, Jimmy. Your own union stabbing you in the back.
Worldwide support, Bill. But we need the leader of our union to ask for it.
Look, you come to Liverpool, right?
Tommy.
Your big speech, standing invasion, what's that about?
Bill.
Do you want us to win? Or was that upset Mr. Blair?
Out of order there, Bill.
That jeopardise your knighthood?
Just say the word, Bill, and we can stop that ship docking.
Yeah.
We can still win.
There's no way we can win.
We're gonna win.
The union's a pile of crap, Dad.
Union leadership's a pile of crap. Not the union.
Same thing.
Eat it!
It's not! We're gonna go to the delegates. We're gonna go to the rank and file. With the whole bloody union on our side. And we're gonna win. We're gonna win!
Eat it! You're not thinking of packing it in, are you?
Well, how Paula's pregnant?
4 months.
So she's gonna have to back in work.
I had a show the other week. They said it's best not to take any chances.
You're not gonna scab it.
For God's sake.
Well, what are you gonna do?
I've got to start in the building.
He lost his job for you. Him and 500.
Yeah, I know, Mum.
Okay, you've got to start. You're lucky. He's 47. He's never going to work again.
Hey, come and see Sadat to the baby. Feeling guilty, Dad. I can turn the clock back, can I? I can't get you unsacked, right?
Right.
Don't be coming in.
What?
You know what? You come in the old arsonist bollocks, Dad. In lifetime in the dock, you forgot what the real world's like. Right, I'm 28. I tour-sized the first proper job I've ever had. The best job I've ever had. That's the reality, Dad.
We fought. Everything
look,
we've got.
It's all agency work.
Every pay rise.
McDonald's and Burger King.
Every bit of progress. We fought for it, son.
Yeah, we were lucky, that's all.
We fought for everything we got.
You were lucky. Right, standards, Diarm's gone. Tate and Lyle, Massey Ferguson, Birdseye. All those factories have gone and you're still here. Why's that? Hey, because you're better men than David here. No, it's because you can't move a dock, that's all. If you're a factory or something, you'd be moved to Taiwan or somewhere years ago, but you're a dock. And you can't move a dock. That's the only reason you're still here. You're nothing special, Dad. Dockers are nothing special.
You're jibbing it, son. You're trying to justify it, but you never will. And pack them in!
No.
You've done your leg.
You get a car!
What? I can't fucking feel it.
I said you get a car!
Hey, don't touch him.
We're getting him the Aussie.
They will phone for an ambulance.
It's quicker by car.
No, don't touch him. He can't feel his leg, so he's done his back in. Right, so don't
we're
fucking
getting
touch him.
Car.
I'll break your fucking neck.
Now, you only want him off this site because it's a fucking death trap, right? He needs an ambulance.
You do this, and you're finished, son.
Oh, fuck off.
Andy, are you up?
Ambulance. Nick Gale, we're on a building site. Come on, the Stanley Road and Arthur Street.
Secretary bangs on about the fabric of the union. How the union might get sued and the fabric of the union might get damaged. What is the fabric of the union, eh? Is it this? Is it the General Secretary's posh office? Is it his posh car? Is it his chauffeur? No. The fabric of the union is the membership. What is the fundamental principle of a union? It's this. The strength of the many will protect the few. Well, you are the many, and we're the few. And you're not protecting us. Look at all this. A whole institution has been built around the principle of the many protecting the few. And you're proud of that institution, aren't you? So proud that 500 dockers can go and rot just so long as you hang on to the buildings, the offices and the mobile fucking phones. Yeah! I'm ashamed of you. We were dismissed for refusing to cross a picket line. And I'm proud to say that we refused to cross that picket line because if people had crossed picket lines in the past, there would be no trade union movement. I beg you now, look at the people up there. Look at them. You are their last chance. Not these. Not these bleeding hypocrites. You. Yes, the rank and file. You're the many. Protect the few. Think about the pain that they've endured for 22 months. And oppose this executive council and support the Liverpool Dockers.
I now put the executive statement to the vote. All those in favour, please show. Thank you. Against? Yeah! The statement is carried.
I'm back.
Andy?
Yeah.
Andy?
I want to tell you what an honour and a privilege it's been to act on your behalf over the last 28 months. We've hit a brick wall, lads. There's no way we can carry on. 5 men have died during the course of this dispute. The Labour government won't lift a finger to help us. And our own union has betrayed us. No way we can carry on.
Hey, make sure she doesn't start in here. I've just cleaned the cab. Jesus.
For God's sake, don't finish it. Please. Please, don't finish it.
Tommy, you were there. Our own leaders stared defeat in the face and told us that they'd won.
We don't need them.
And then when we won our card vote, they just ignored it.
We don't need them.
What chance have we got with leaders like that? Our recommendation is, lads, that we accept the offer that's on the table. Come on now. All those in favour. All those against. It's all over, lads.
Really lovely.
To give him something bigger.
Hey, you have to.
Failed.
Look. I didn't want to believe the things you believe in, mate. I thought he was a bit of a dinosaur, like. I was just feeling embarrassed by you.
Thanks.
You're welcome. But Dad, I was wrong. I mean, you fought so hard for things, you passed them on, and, you know, I've lost them. But I'm going to get them back one day, and then I can pass them on, you know, and it doesn't make me feel embarrassed. No, but it makes me feel proud.
Dad, come on. Last one. Andy, come on.
Last one.